was the tradition of not only people participating in the conferences, one way we participated was also you were invited to wash dishes together. I washed dishes with the finance minister of Chad, and you have a totally different conversation than you would have. I was served ice cream by the former president of the Red Cross. You interact with people differently when you can serve with them and serve others. I very much profoundly believe in its mission. I believe in the power of a beautiful place to also give perspective, the view, the history, but also the mission of trying to connect personal change with global change, that we can all deeply ask ourselves, what is the change that I want to see in the world, and how can I start with myself? Before I was in the private sector, and obviously there was negotiating on relationships and prices and so on. It's just perhaps not that different from negotiating in international affairs. I would say my key takeaway was always learn or have clear what the expectations are. How do other people see your role? Perhaps there's certain times where maybe you are not the right person to be in that position. You can help in the negotiation, but who needs to carry or speak to it, I think sometimes needs consideration. But I think it's also the beginning, it's the kick off of a really great conversation that continues all week and of course needs to continue for the next few years. I mean, how do we collaborate better? It's just an ongoing conversation, and you need to create spaces and sometimes pause and come to spaces like this where you have this view and perspective on things of how can we do this better, and we're going to need to do a lot of learning and thinking. So I'm happy to help contribute to that conversation tomorrow. I think there is a way of becoming more united and at the same time distinct in what we do. And that's why you need spaces like this where the answers aren't clear, so we come and share and little by little move forward step by step together. And if there are strong relationships, which the Center for Competence and Humanitarian Negotiation has already created, then the relationships are there and help the ongoing conversation continue and people learn from each other on a continuous basis. So I would hope that in the next 10 years, with whatever unpredictable pandemics or world crises and challenges from climate change and all else that is thrown at us, that we've created more links within these sectors of how we can continue learning from each other. And then we can deal with whatever unexpected things come, but there are more links and relationships between us. And there I really do foresee CCCHN being able to help build those bridges, because it's already built quite a few within the humanitarian sector itself. And I'm just looking forward to those unplanned moments when, you know, all this work that you guys have done to create the space for people to interact happens. So I think in all those open spaces that are created for conversations, that's what I'm looking forward to. Of course, all the other structured things are nice, but it's the unstructured, serendipitous ones that I think bring the most magic and even added value to these sort of events. I think it is a chance to be part of a historic moment where all these different organizations come together on one panel and come together in a historic way, which are both hybrid. So online, in here, in this beautiful building. And I think that is something also just interesting to be a part of. And then it's a great way to just step into the rest of the conversations for the rest of the week. So I think it's a great way to start your week. It's Monday morning. Sometimes that's a little hard to get out of bed for, but here is something interesting that I think will give food for thought for the week and for the years to come.